Headline News Update.
Good morning, everybody. I'm Tommy O'Brien coming to you live from TFNN, 9 a.m. Eastern Time, Friday morning, January 3rd, kicking things off. And we have a little bit of negative action, a little bit of drama going on in the Middle East with the U.S. taking out an Iranian general and markets reacting to the negative side. S&P futures down 30 points right now at 32.29. NASDAQ futures down 94 points at 87.97. Dow futures off 240, 28,601. We'll start things off. Let's check it out with the chart of the S&P. Last night, 6 p.m. Eastern time, we make it to an all-time high in the S&Ps at 32.63. And then you want to talk about a sell-off. The S&P sell off almost 60 points. Excuse me, battling a little bit of a cold this morning. 60 points to a low of 32.06 just prior to 6 a.m. We've gotten a little bit of a pop from there. 32.27 right now in those S&P futures, down about 30 points from yesterday's close. We'll jump over to the charts. We'll start things off with the indices. There's your S&Ps that we covered. Low of 32.06, currently at 32.27. NASDAQ 100, much the same. We go from last night at 6 o'clock. 8 o'clock is when the news begins to break. 89.05. You trade down more than 150 NASDAQ 100 points to 87.36. We're currently at 87.91. Dow 30, you go from last night almost at 28,900, we'll call it. That's almost 500 Dow points, folks, to 28,434, currently 28,586. Crude oil spiking higher. We actually made it above $64. Turmoil in the Middle East, potentially raising the price of oil. Gold contract trading higher as well, $1,553, quite a price tag for the price of gold. And the euro US dollar currently trading at 111.35. In terms of what else you have happening, I just wanted to give you a quick summation. And it's not often that the front page of CNBC, if you look at it, every single headline here has to do with that event taking place. You have the military leader in terms of being taken out by the U.S. You look at this, every single one, dangerous escalation, oil prices surge, how Democrats reacted, an op-ed, Iran vowing to retaliate, Trump's tweets, and five things to know as the markets open following a U.S. airstrike on the top Iran military leader. Something not to be underscored. I can't remember the last time I've seen eight headlines on the front page of CNBC all having to do with the same event. Stay tuned, folks. Larry Pesavento coming up live. I'll be back at 10 o'clock with Tom. We'll be right back.